Hey my friends, today we are here to look at willow. This is a powerful plant that grows all along the water's edge, and it's springtime, so it's bark season. It's the time to harvest barks like this. This plant has been used as a natural painkiller since 400 BCE in Hippocrates' time, and it's been used all through the ages. In fact, it is what aspirin comes from originally. So we're going to look at this plant, look at some of the morphology, how it shows up, how it can be used as medicine, and how to make it into an extract. Join me in discovering willow bark. Before we talk about the medicinal qualities of willow, it's important to get to know this plant and how to identify it. This plant grows all over the world. We see 350 plus species of this around the world, but there's a few key factors that we can identify this plant with very different from other plants. So one of the first things is it loves wet feet. This is a watery plant, so you'll see it near marshlands and near water sources. In fact, this is an old way to find a water source, is to look for a willow tree. Now, like I said, it grows tall, it grows small, there's many different forms of it, so we can identify them all with some certain similarities. Like this one looks nothing like a giant weeping willow, but it's got similarities. In the spring, when these leaves come out, they're long and lanceolate, and they are alternatively added to the stems here like this, just like the pussy willows are at this time. Now right now we're in the flower season, and all of the willows have these kind of pussy willows. The other thing to know about it is they've all got these very bendy, supple, smaller branches. This was often used to bind things to as a type of twine or to weave baskets, right? There's a lot of willow furniture. There's a lot of history around working with this plant, both in a medicinal way, as well as a functional way, as well as a magical way. So we're going to talk about a few of those. And the other thing to get to know about this plant, if you're trying to identify it, is if you can't figure it out, peel off a little bit of this bark. And this bark has a very much an aspirin-like taste. It's very unique. And when you chew on it for a little bit of time, you get that aspirin flavor on every single willow. Out of all the species, there's not one willow that doesn't contain salicylic acid or other derivatives of that type of compound. So you'll get that aspirin-like flavor every time you try willow bark. Even just by tasting this, you can tell that there's some potent chemistry in there. You can taste the tannins and the salicylic acids. You can taste all of that kind of aspirin-like taste, but you also can taste that there's a lot of phenolic compounds, and most of us don't understand what this chemistry is, but you can get that sense of strong, medicinally active chemistry in this. And so I want to talk a bit about the medicine of this plant, because it's not just a magic bullet for a headache. It has a lot more to it. Like all plants, this is a complicated dance of chemistry that's happening in this plant. And how we'd extract it is going to be using those chemical compounds to understand the best way to get that medicine out. Because you can taste the medicine in this, it's one of those ones that you can actually go and try different species. And like right here I have pussy willow, and here I have our Pacific willow, and they have very different tastes. I can tell that this pussy willow is actually a stronger willow in its flavor. So that's the one I'm going to probably work with more of, but I'm going to try to make a medicine with both of these today and see which one seems to have a better effect on reducing pain and fever and headaches and all these kinds of things. So for today's sake, we're going to harvest ones off of these areas where we've already cut them along the edge of the water. But as you can see, this plant grows to be really tall. Many of these will grow into good-sized trees, and they become homes for the birds, and they're just a wonderful habitat. I love these pussy willows. I mean, this is the black willow. You can tell by its blacker, kind of darker stem, but it has these beautiful fuzzy pussy willows, and there's just something soft and gentle about those. So the medicine to this, intuitively from a doctrine of signature, would be kind of softer and gentler for more of that soft tissue. So it's actually traditionally that the pussy willow is used more for gonorrhea and for ovarian cramping and for pain around our soft tissue areas, whereas our white willow was commonly used for more arthritis and fever and these kinds of things. Now, all of them have similar chemistry, but it's interesting how different willows have been used for different things at different times. When we look at willow, it's often been that it was there to restore balance and retrieve one from a state of imbalance and pain. So this might be from joint pain, from wears and tears, because we see that willow is great for this, for those kind of sport injuries or those wears and tears. The osteoarthritis, not the rheumatoid arthritis, but that osteoarthritis where we have that pain and inflammation. This is because willow works on combating and anti-inflammatory compounds. It has these glycosides and these flavonoids and these polyphenol compounds that are all very antioxidant and protective against free radical damage. This is why it works with joint inflammation on that level. Plus the salicin in it is a pain reducer. So that's one of the ways it can be used, but we've also seen that it's been used for working with headaches and people who get not migraines, but just gentle headaches to reduce the pain that way. That's what often people use aspirin for, which is derived originally from willow. But we've also seen that willow can work with many smooth muscle pains. So that's where cramping and stuff comes in, nausea. We've seen it to be useful for things like fevers and to reduce that kind of swelling and to bring down the heat. Willow is definitely counterindicated with blood thinners because it thins the blood, but it's also one of those ones we don't use on long-term use. We should be using it sporadically for specific things. That's why it works so powerfully for relieving pain, because hopefully we're not in pain long-term chronic. We get painful situations and we move out of them, and that's where willow becomes a great medicine. This plant has been used for so many things throughout the ages. I mean, everything from the headaches to the fevers to the tension to the cramping, but we also see things like externally as a wash for using for sores and wound care to help reduce the pain and has some antiseptic qualities to it. We also see it as a gargle for mouth pain. So this is a great one if you're in any kind of pain like that. We've seen it used as an eyewash. This is a gentle plant that can be used as an eyewash if we've got pain in our eye or to rinse out the eye. It's got tannins in there that will tighten the tissues and strengthen it, and is slightly antiseptic. So it's a great plant to have around for all these qualities. But the biggest thing about this plant is that it removes us from a state of imbalance. That's the thing that willow does. And pain is just one of those indicators that we need to shift. Because willow is such a powerful pain medicine, I wanted to talk to you a bit about the acronym for pain. This is something one of my teachers shared with me, and I just think it's really invaluable to understand pain from this level. So let's look at pain. It's P-A-I-N, which happens to represent getting present. Every time you get into a painful situation, you have to get really, really present, right? When you get a wound, boom, you're present. This builds awareness. This goes, aha, some awareness of my body, of my situation, of where I am in life. This transforms into insight. We gain some insight into how we might do this different, how that might have been partly our fault. All these different ways of looking at it from that perspective. Next comes N, which is new. So we transform pain through getting present, becoming aware, finding insight, and building into a new reality. This is what pain is all about, triggering that. So willow might be one of those medicines we can work with, but know that if we have pain in our life, it's an opportunity to create new situations, to create new ways of showing up. So a few more of the benefits of willow is that it actually has some antibacterial and antiviral and antipathogenic qualities. This is actually one of the ways it works with reducing colds and fevers, not just for reducing the head kind of cold or breaking the fever, but actually for having some of those antipathogenic qualities. We've also seen, because of that, you can soak a bandage in a willow bark tea and pack it onto a wound, and it'll help heal it a lot faster that way. It's also been used as a hair rinse for things like dandruff and all of the different skin inflammation type things like eczema. So beyond its medicinal qualities, this has been used as a very magical plant, and right now is willow season. If you go back to the old Celtic calendars, every month has a tree. The willow season is in April through May. It's around Beltane. It's around this revival of the renewing. This is one of those trees that was used for all kinds of spell casting and weaving magic, not just in weaving baskets, but weaving magic. It was the binder to bind a spell. And the idea behind willow is when you go deep into willow, which is in the watery areas ruled by the moon, you are transformed and you come out anew with with better protection and perspective and not so easily influenced by outside forces. I think this is an important thing for the times right now because there's a lot of these outside forces that are affecting us. And willow, despite it being a modern age, still has some old medicinal qualities to it and old magic qualities that we can embrace in our lives right now. In fact, one cool thing is, you know, the witch's broom? Traditionally, this was made from three trees. It was made from ash for the broom handle, birch for the broom itself, and willow to bind it all together, to cast the spell. There's magic to this plant. In fact, there's magic to all plants. But here's one that throughout the ages has had a lot of medicinal and magic qualities to it. So I invite you to look at some of the magical qualities of willow. I'll say from my perspective, it's one that helps us bend and be more flexible, to reach down into the depths of our soul, to dream up the reality we want to have in the world. So that's kind of why I like willow. I consider myself to be one of the willow tribe, the kind of adaptable, mutable type people. And this is one of those power plants that works for me, and I feel like has a lot more to it that is underneath the surface. I want to make sure that we talk about how to make this into medicine, because it's really easy. We're going to use the bark, right? The inner cambium layer right here is where we want to use. So we want to harvest this. My preference is to use a pair of pruning shears and to use a nice little sharp knife like so. So what we're going to do is I'm going to harvest a few of these and show you how to make them into a medicine. So when we go to harvest willow, we don't have to do it in the spring before the leaves shoot out, although that is the ideal time because right now all the chi and energy is moving through the bark. We're looking for the inner cambium layer. That's what has the most potency. And I like to harvest these long ones because they're much easier to peel. So I'll get down and thin out right from the middle of one of these stands. So now this is what I'm gonna use as medicine. I've set up a little blanket here, and I'm just gonna show you some basic things about harvesting it and about processing it. I like to use a blanket because it's easy to catch all of my shavings instead of try to get them into a basket or something. And I'm just gonna go along just down here and shave this off. So what we're trying to do is essentially get off all of this kind of down to the inner cambium layer. And when we get up to the very top of it, you'll see that it's quite a bit easier to peel off all of the bits. Now I'm going to take them and dry them for a couple of days till they look like these ones. This is now easy to store in a bag for a long time. We can make this into medicine at any time. So pretty much I'll just put them in these little containers, dry them up, and you can see I've got both here. I've got both the darker pussy willow and this lighter Pacific willow. Both of these are powerful medicine. I'm going to make a tincture with each one and work with them to see which one I like better for harvesting next year. That's how I like to work with plants, is to test and tweak and play. So these dried pieces of bark are what we're going to use to make a tea or to make any kind of medicine. Essentially, one of the easiest ways to work with this though is to make what's called a decoction. That's to lightly simmer this for an hour or so and make it into tea. I would take a handful like this to make 2 to 3 cups of tea. Really simply, a teaspoon of dried herb to a teacup. So just think of a handful of this as a 3 or 4. Now we can decoct this 2 to 3 times. I've seen very much a lot of flavor still left in the third brew of a willow bark tea. This can also be added to many different herbs if we want to make it a better flavor than that. Maybe we want to add a little honey to this. Maybe we want to add some other compounds in it to make our tea as a decoction. Another way we can work with this is to make a tincture. You break them up into small pieces, pack the jar as full as you can, and then add 40% alcohol, preferably vodka or Everclear or something clear, to it and let it sit for another 2 weeks. This is an easy medicine. Then we can have a much more concentrated extraction of this to be able to use smaller amounts and therefore get away with small concentrated doses that don't have such an irritation on the stomach. All right. Those are a few ways to make this into a medicine. I can also say that you could easily powder it and put it into a capsule, but I find when you extract it like this, when you break apart some of the tannins, when you make it more bioavailable, you're going to get a much better willow bark medicine. I just love how willows show up. I love when they're in flower like this. They're so soft, all these little pussy willows. I might take one for my hat. And I just find the way this plant shows up is so majestic. It reaches down deep. It has this magical quality that helps me reflect in my dream state almost It's almost like it's a lucid plant, and I feel that way when I'm walking through the bogs in the marshes along the edges of willow. Or when I go out to a willow tree and I sit down, it has this dreamlike quality that it brings me to that space. So thank you for joining me in looking at willow and exploring this plant. This is a powerful one, and it's really useful for not just practical first aid things, but also for working with at a deeper level. I hope you start playing with this plant and you find some this year to work with as medicine. Like I've often said, may the forest be with you, my friends. And if you like the content in this video, please share it, please comment, please let me know how you like to work with this plant, and follow our channel and check out some of the other great videos we do on working with plants as medicine. Remember, they are people's medicine, and this is power to the people, my friend. So thank you. We'll see you soon.